Students, so in this video we are discussing one of the important lesson. So that lesson name is mineral resource. So in this chapter we are discussing about what are the important mineral resource we can see in India and what are the uses and which are the part we can see the minerals, and we are discussing types of minerals also. So these are the points we are discussing in this video. So first one, we want to know what is mean by minerals. So the definition of minerals, so already we are knowing the earth is made up of rocks. This one we already knowing. The earth is created, or inside of earth crust we can see only a rocks. So in that rocks, composed by, means made up by different substance, we can see different components or different factors. So these factors or components only we are called as a minerals. So that means now we are understood what is mean by minerals. Minerals means our earth is made up as a rocks. So in that rocks, made up are composed by different substance. So this substance only we are called as a minerals. So now we want to know next one, the types of the minerals. So before that, we want to know what are the uses in that minerals. So these minerals we are using for manufacturing purpose and constructions purpose. So in that both for also we are using by minerals. Some of the minerals we are using for constructions purpose, means to build a buildings, as some other roads, bridges. So in that purpose are industries. Some of the things or some of the minerals we are using for the purpose of manufacturing. For example, home appliance or electrical items. So in that based we are using some of the minerals. So that's why they're saying the main uses of minerals, that is manufacturing and another one is constructions. So in that purpose only we are using. And next here they're saying some of the minerals we can see in earth surface, means top of the layer of the earth. Some of the minerals we can see in top of the earth surface, but some of the minerals we want to get in inside of the earth crust. Inside of earth or earth crust only some of the minerals we are getting, and some of the minerals we are getting in ocean beds also. So that means now we want to know which are the minerals we are getting in earth surface, which are the minerals we are getting in earth crust and in ocean beds. So examples we can see, we can know already. So in earth surface we are getting sand, so that is one of the important minerals, so that one we are getting in earth surface. And in earth crust we can see different minerals, iron ore, magnesium, aluminium, manganese, and we can see petroleum products also we are getting in earth crust. And third one, in ocean beds, which are the minerals we are getting in ocean beds. So one of the best mineral, that is petroleum ore. So this one, most of the part we are getting petroleum ore in ocean beds. So these, like, we can see in different stages or different parts we are getting by minerals. Some of the minerals in earth surface, some of the minerals in earth crust, some of the minerals in ocean beds. So these, like, we are getting in different forms of minerals in different parts. So students, now we have understood that means what is mean by minerals and in which are the place we are getting by these are the minerals and what was the main uses of minerals. So that also now we have understood. So next one, now we want to know types of minerals. So in that minerals we can see there are two types. So first one, metallic minerals. Second one is non-metallic minerals. So now in this video we are discussing what is meant by metallic minerals and examples, and second one, non-metallic minerals and examples. So that only now we can see one by one. So first of all, first one we want to know what is meant by metallic minerals. So metallic minerals means this is made up by mineral, means metal, and this is not break easily, could not break easily, these like of forms of minerals. So which minerals we are called as a metal, sorry, metallic minerals, दिस इज फॉर्म्ड बाय एज अ मेटल एंड दिस इज नॉट ब्रेक ईजली कुड नॉट ब्रेक ईजली सो दिस लेक ऑफ मिनरल्स वी कैन कॉल्ड एज ए मेटालिक मिनरल्स एंड दिस लेक ऑफ मिनरल्स वी आर गेटिंग इन ओर सो ईच मिनरल्स वॉट वी आर गेटिंग बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वन वी आर गेटिंग लार्ज क्वांटिटी सो दिस लार्ज क्वांटिटी अमाउंट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर मिनरल्स वी आर कॉल्ड एज ए ओर सो इन दैट वो द एक्सट्रैक्टिंग द मिनरल्स एंड वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग डिफरेंट थिंग्स एंड वी आर यूजिंग डिफरेंट पर्पस सो दैट मीन्स वी वॉन्ट टू नो सो वॉट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटालिक मिनरल्स वी कैन सी इन इंडिया सो हियर वी कैन सी सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटालिक मिनरल्स वी कैन सी ऑन दैट बेस्ट आयरन कॉपर जिंक मैग्नीशियम मैंगनीज आफ्टर दैट सिल्वर निकल गोल्ड एंड अल्यूमिनियम सो दीज आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट मिनरल्स मेटालिक मिनरल्स वी कैन सी इन इंडिया आयरन कॉपर जिंक मैंगनीज सिल्वर निकल गोल्ड एंड अल्यूमिनियम सो दीज आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट मिनरल्स मेटालिक मिनरल्स वी कैन सी आर वी कैन फाउंड इन इंडिया सो इन दैट अल्यूमिनियम दिस इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ आर एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम बॉक्साइट इन बॉक्साइट वी आर गेटिंग बाय अल्यूमिनियम सो स्टूडेंट्स नाउ वी वॉन्ट टू नो दैट मीन्स वन बाय वन सो वाट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटालिक मिनरल्स एंड विच आर द पार्ट और विच आर द स्टेट्स वी आर गेटिंग द पर्टिकुलर मेटालिक मिनरल्स एंड वाट आर द यूजेस फॉर ईच मिनरल्स सो दैट मेनली नाउ वी वॉन्ट टू नो So first one here they given that is copper. So copper this is one of the valuable metal in India, not only in India, in world. Because of why this one is one of the valuable metal? So because of this is a good conductor of electricity. In electrical appliance, most of the part we are using by this copper. So this is most needable part for electrical appliance. So that's why copper. This is one of the most valuable resource or minerals in a world. Not only in a world, in our country also. This is one of the important valuable part. And next one here they saying, but we are using different purpose of these minerals. We are making different electrical items. But in our country, these minerals, they not have that much of quantity. This is very less in India. Copper. The uses are more, but when you are discussing about the deposit of copper in India, that is very less. We are not getting that much of copper in India. But some of the regions, some of the states, we can see these copper minerals. So which are the states we can find out these copper minerals in India? So they are saying by in the place of Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Jharkhand, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat. Jharkhand, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat. So in these places we can see or we can get a deposition of coppers we can find out in these states. So now we understood that means one of the important minerals we can see in India that is copper. But the deposit or quantity, that much of quantity we cannot get in India. And another point also we understood that is this is a good conductor of electricity. So this is we are using for different purpose. So that also now we have discussed. So after copper, second one important metallic minerals we can see in India. So that is here they given iron. So iron also one of the important metallic minerals in India. So this also we are using for different purpose. We are using as iron and steel also we are producing in that same iron ore. And here the same by this one we are using for to make machines. Tools, next one medical tools, not only this one, agriculture tools and vehicles and not only this one and household appliance and railway, after that bridges and buildings, constructions. So in these purpose for we are using by iron. That means iron also we are using for different purpose. They have different uses in iron. Not only one purpose. This iron ore or iron we are using for different purpose to construct industries or manufacturing and home appliance so these like we can see different purpose for we are using by iron ore and here they say And this iron, this is one of the important metallic minerals in India. We can see large amount of deposition of iron ore in India. And one of the important economically, we are getting more income based on in this iron ore deposit. We can see so many of industries in India based on iron and steel manufacturing industries. So we can see so many industries. So that's why they're saying, so iron and steel industries, this is one of the important industries. It is also giving so much of contribution to progress of our country. So that's why this is also one of the important iron ore or important metallic minerals. So next one we want to know, that means in which are the place we are seeing or we are getting by iron ore. So in the place of Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Odisha, after that Bengal, and another one is here given by Andhra Pradesh. So in these regions we can get iron ore. So already I told, so this is one of the important metallic minerals we can see in India. And large amount of depositions also we can see in India. When you are comparing to copper, so this amount or quantity is very large in India. So that like they saying. So after that, next third one important metallic minerals in India, that is aluminium. So aluminium, so this is also one of the important metallic minerals in India. And this is very, very lightweight. And easily we can flexible it. So, and this one is rust-proof metal. So when you are comparing to iron, this is rust-proof metal and we can easily flexible it. And this is very lightweight mineral. So that like of features we can see for aluminium. And this aluminium we are using for different purpose. For example, house, appliance, this also we are using. And not only this one, to make aeroplanes, so we are using by this only aluminium. And ships, automobiles industries, and electrical wire. So in this purpose for we are using by this aluminium. And not only this one, nowadays this is one of the important substitute for wood manufacturing industries. So nowadays people, they are using as a home appliance as a this aluminium, because of this is very lightweight and we can flexible it, and rust proof also this one metal. So that's why most of the people nowadays for home appliance they are using by aluminium, especially in wood manufacturing industries or wood manufacturing making also nowadays they converted to aluminium. So that much of uses we can see for the minerals aluminium. And next one we want to know, so in which are the states we can get this aluminium? So in the place of Odisha, the Tamil Nadu, Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, Jharkhand, and Maharashtra. So in these regions we can see or we can find out the deposition of aluminium. And this is one of the most important metal we are using for different purpose. And we are discussed the features also. This is lightweight and easily flexible it. And another one is, this is rust proof metal. So this is one of the important metal we can see in India. So after that, next one here they given, that is manganese. So manganese also one of the important metal in India. And this one we are using for to make a steel. And some of the, this one manganese we are using for to chemical product and glass steel industries. So these purpose for we are using by manganese for the purpose of making a steel, and after that to create a chemicals, and another one is glass making industries. So in this purpose for we are using by manganese. And next one we want to know, in which are the states we are getting by manganese? So here they say, in the place of Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, after that Maharashtra, Goa, and Karnataka. So in these regions we can see the mineral of manganese. So these like we can see in India's some important metallic minerals. First one is we are discussed about copper, after that iron, after that aluminium, and last one we are discussed about manganese. So these like we can see some important metallic minerals deposited in or found in India. So after that, next one we want to know, that is non-metallic minerals. So still now we are discussed about only a metallic minerals. So next now we want to discuss about So non-metallic minerals. What is meant by non-metallic minerals and examples, and what are the uses for non-metallic minerals? So that only now we want to discuss. So here they say, so this is what is meant by non-metallic minerals. First of all, that only we want to know. So the definition of non-metallic minerals, this is not getting a metallic shine. We are not seeing like a metallic shine. Metal, we can see a shine. But in this non-metallic shine, metallics, we cannot see that much of shine. And second one here, the same way, these metals, non-metallic metals, means non-metallic minerals, we can break easily. So that means, students, now we are understood what is meant by non-metallic minerals. That is, no metallic shines and we can break easily. So these like of structures or features of minerals, we can call it as a non-metallic minerals. And we can see some of the important examples for non-metallic minerals. We can see sand, coal, gypsum, petroleum and limestone. So these are the important non-metallic minerals we can see as a examples. Coal, sand, gypsum, petroleum and limestone. So these are the important non-metallic minerals. So now we want to know one by one, which are the things we can see, which are the non-metallic minerals we can found in India. So in that first one, we want to know gypsum. So what was the purpose we are using by gypsum? So gypsum, this non-metallic minerals we are using for the main purpose to make a cement. So this gypsum, this is a non-metallic minerals. So this one, majorly we are using the purpose of to make a cement. So in that purpose only we are using by gypsum. So after that, second one important non-metallic minerals in India, so that is coal. Coal, this is one of the important metallic minerals in ancient as well as present also. In ancient time of India's peoples, they also used this only same coal, but still now also present also, now also still now we are using this coal. So this is one of the important non-metallic minerals we can see in India. And here they say, so what was the important this one of this coal? So this is one of the important energy source of India. This is one of the important energy source. So in that base, some of them we are using for domestic purpose. This one, coal, for the purpose of cooking or eating. Not only this one, nowadays we are using for to generate a thermal power. Means we are using now electrical energy. So in that purpose for also we are using by coal. Coal, this is one of the important non-metallic minerals. So this one we are using for different domestic purpose. For cooking, to eating, to heat, not only this one, after that to generate thermal power. So in this purpose for we are using by coal. And next one we want to know, so in which are the states we can get this non-metallic mineral of coal? So here they are saying by Jharkhand, West Bengal, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. Jharkhand, West Bengal, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. So in these places we are getting by coal, or we can see deposit of coal. So that like they are saying. So after that, next one we want to know, third one important metallic, non-metallic minerals in India. So that is petroleum or crude oil. Petroleum or crude oil. So this is one of the important non-metallic minerals in India. And this is one of the valuable resource in India. And we can see some of the features of this resource. So this non-metallic minerals we can get as a form of thick. Not only this one, dark form also we can see. And this one we can see in deep interior part of in our earth crust. So these like a petroleum ore or crude oil we are getting in the place of interior place of in earth crust. So in that place only we are getting by petroleum. And some of the place we are getting in seabeds also. Some of the place this petroleum product deposited in interior part of in earth crust, and some of the place we are getting petroleum product in seabeds. So one of the important place for seabeds we are getting by this one petroleum product. So one of the best example, Bombay High or Mumbai High. This one located in India. So here we are getting petroleum product in the place of sea beds. And in interior part of earth crust, so we already knowing in Gulf countries, one of the most important countries, they are leading producing of petroleum product. So these like we are getting petroleum in two parts of our earth. One is interior part of our earth crust, and second one in sea beds. In both places also we are getting. So next one we want to know, in India, in which are the part we are getting by this petroleum product? In the place of Gujarat, Assam and part of Maharashtra. So in that place we can get petroleum products. In India also we can see some of the place, this quantity also very less, but in some of the regions we can see this one petroleum product in India. One is Odisha, Assam, Gujarat and Maharashtra. So in this place we can get petroleum product. And this petroleum product we can use as a directly. So when you are getting in the interior of earth crust, we can use it that one directly? No. They have some of the important processing method, refining method. So in India, we can see some of the important refining factories. In different part, we can see in the place of Mumbai, Goa, Mangalore, and Chennai and Kochi. So in these regions, we can see refinery factories. So these refinery factories, they're refining the petroleum product. In petroleum, we are getting different parts, different ores or different minerals, non-metallic minerals. So which are the non-metallic minerals we are getting in petroleum? So here they're saying by cooking gas, kerosene, petrol, diesel and petroleum jelly. So these like we can see there are different products, sub-products we are getting in petroleum ore. So these product, who is there doing? They have manufacturing factories, that only we are saying by refineries. So they're dividing petroleum as a petrol, diesel, kerosene, cooking gas. So these like they're doing made up, there are different sub-product in petroleum ore. And this petroleum ore, we are given another name also, that is black gold. So this petroleum product or petroleum, we are called as another name, we are given another title, that is black gold. So that like they're saying. And not only this one, this petroleum product we are using for another purpose also, for the purpose of dyes, not only this one, for the purpose of paints and drugs, some of them they're using by the productions of chemicals. So in that purpose for also people, they are using by petroleum product. So these like students, we can see some of the important non-metallic minerals they deposited in India. We can see sand and gypsum, not only this one. After that we have discussed about coal and finally we have discussed about petroleum. And finally we want to know the conservations of resource. Because of, so what we have discussed till now, metallic minerals and non-metallic minerals, so these are the minerals is non-renewable resource. So once if you are used, if you want to get once again that much of quantity or quality of that particular minerals, we want to wait thousands about of years. So these are the minerals are non-renewable resource. So that's why we want to use how much possible, that much limited purpose for only we want to use, these are the natural minerals. Because of this is non-renewable. We want to, once if you use that one minerals, if you once again we want to use it or we want to get it in that place, we want to wait, there are so many of years. So otherwise we cannot get. So that's why nowadays government as well as non-government, so both institutions also, they are giving more importance about renewable resource. Naturally, we are getting some of the renewable resources. For example, we can see sunlight and winds. So in that waste, we can get some of the energy and we can use it. And on that waste, we can move our life. So that's why nowadays, most of the peoples, not only peoples, government as well as non-government institutions also, they are giving more importance about the uses of renewable resource. Because of what we discussed till now, these are the things are non-renewable resource. So next generation, future generation, they also want to see and they want to also consume these other things. Because this earth for all, not only for one person or one group of community, no. This is for all. So that's why when we are using for these are the minerals, we want to remain it. So what was the points we want to know? This is non-renewable resource. So how much of possible, that much only we want to use it. Because of, we want to save these are the resource. Because of future generation also, they also want to use it, these only same minerals. So that's why we want to know the conserve of resource. So students, so in this class we have discussed, that means there are some important points about mineral resource. One is metallic minerals, second one is non-metallic minerals, and we have discussed about examples and which are the states. So these are the minerals was found. So these are the important points we have discussed in this video. So next class we can discuss about next another one important lesson. Okay, thank you.